You want a cough?
Nah, I'm good.
Sure?
Yep.
Okay,
give me I'm clear.
Good morning, party people.
Welcome to The Breakdown with Nath and Johnny. We are checking out Bad Omens today. The Death of Peace of Mind. That's a mouthful. Say that five times.
The Death of Peace of Mind. Fuck, I couldn't say it once.
Brilliant. Yeah, look, Bad Omens are a secret favourite of mine. And I say secret in the sense that now everybody knows.
Shh.
Don't tell anyone. But they're just a band that, like, every time I hear them, I'm like, fuck, I love this band. So I'm interested to hear what they do next.
They had a very big Bring Me the Horizon vibe in the past, like the That's the Spirit era.
Yeah, the album, their last album was The Finding God Until God Finds something or other. It had a really long name, but yeah, it still had some of those moments. Like, and when Ammo came out, and I wasn't and still not a huge fan of Ammo, it was like Bad Omens were the band that I went to because I got my little sort of Bring Me the Horizon fix without having to listen to Bring Me the Horizon.
They have got a little bit more melodic since then, though, so it will be interesting to see what we get with this brand new track. If you guys would like to subscribe, that'd be sick.
Yes. You guys have requested this one a lot. So yeah, like Nate said, like, subscribe, check out the merch. We love you.
We do. 3, 2, 1.
Who's that sound like?
Oh, look, it's The Weeknd.
It's like, why are you looking at your watch?
It's checking the date, my friend. Making a joke about what day it is and then being The Weeknd.
I thought you were checking your whoop stream because I've already paused it 22 seconds in.
No, that's fine. I was at the whoops on this wrist.
Of course, yeah, for you.
I wear a watch and a whoop. Everyone's like, why is he wearing two watches? Yeah, that's my fitness tracker. That's so I can see if we listen to The Weeknd.
It's two watches. One's on normal time and one's on Johnny time. So he's like, he's fucking late. And then he checks his Johnny time watch. He goes, oh no, he's still got a few minutes left.
He never has a few minutes left. You're gonna keep it. Oh yeah.
So The Weeknd. That gives me heavy Billie Eilish vibes.
It's that real, like, throbbing bass tone. He said bass tone.
Yeah. Such a child. Perfect timing, and I didn't actually...
Interesting having just the credits come in the middle of the song.
Yeah, that is interesting.
You're absolutely right. Do you know what this song is so far?
No, I tried to think of a dumb joke. Go ahead.
You are a dumb joke. It's Sleep Token featuring The Weeknd.
Ah, yeah, fully. I also, when it kicked in, I got like the Plot in You vibes.
Yeah, fully, yeah. Particularly when he has a little like whispered bit.
Whispered.
I love a whisper. Even that, like, whoa bit in the background. And we love a whoa.
Yeah, we love a whoa. You come and go and where's Sleep Token, anyone? That was so well done. That was so tastefully interjected there. I loved that.
I stand by what I said. It's Sleep Token featuring The Weeknd.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Get it, son. Cool back. Yeah, right. That was cool. Now, I can see this song being a little bit polarizing for fans of the band. I can see a lot of people finding it potentially too far removed, or potentially too slow, or potentially not exciting for their taste. I can see that if you're a fan of their heavier stuff. But me, I think that was just a really, really beautiful song, really well crafted, really dark, and it was the perfect way to do something new, but then, like, you know, that middle section interject what the fans love you for, I guess, like the heavy moments. It was a really sort of dark and moving song.
Yeah, it did. It was fairly simplistic in, or repetitive in that, yeah. In very accessible in that way.
Yeah.
But the song built through the whole way through.
Exactly, yeah.
So yeah, you didn't necessarily get bored, but you could also get into it and for follow sure the groove the whole way
and
through.
I think it gives it that repetitive feel because it was the same tempo the whole way and the guitar wasn't doing any different strumming patterns. It was all just dun 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 dun.
Yeah.
Like it was just those. But yeah, like you said, it was the progression of the song. It's what the song is meant to do and where it's meant to start and finish. It's got that big crescendo in the middle and then it brings you back to the chorus, has those little sort of twists on the vocal melody that make it interesting and fun. A cool little guitar riff like came in over the back. That song is all about the journey, all about the progression, and I think they did it really well and really tasteful. And it doesn't hurt that he's got a fucking phenomenally beautiful voice.
He does have a crazy good voice for that genre, and it is nice to hear him stretch it out a little bit and play with it in that way. I really liked that. I thought that was cool. That was different to what we've heard from them, but it was a nice progression. What did you guys think? It's very important to us. We want to know your opinion.
We care what you think. We really do. Unless it's about me and it's like, Johnny's an idiot.
For those of you that have... they all think that.
Yeah.
For those of you that have requested that, is it because you wanted to hear what we thought about the newer style there, or is it just because you like the song? Let us know, and we will see you guys...
on the next one?
On the next one.
We better. We'd miss you.
Every time you're not hearing this.